Hello friends, this video will show you the communication between BACnet device and LabVIEW. Before performing the actual topic, let's have some brief idea for those who are new to BACnet. BACnet is a communication protocol which stands for Building Automation and Control Network. It is developed by ASHRAE and is still governed by ASHRAE. BACnet protocol was specifically designed for building automations, which includes HVAC, that is heating, ventilation and air conditioning devices. Why BACnet becomes so popular in automation industry? The reason is interoperability and interchangeability. In previous days, there was no compatibility between two devices made of different manufacturer. Let's take an example. The building owner who has control devices from manufacturer X in his company premises, and he wants to expand their facilities with the new control devices made of manufacturer Y. But he cannot do that because there is no compatibility between two devices. Because the devices from different manufacturer using the different communication protocol in order to exchange their information. To resolve this issue, the team of BACnet came up with a new idea, and they have standardized the protocol in a such a way in which all the manufacturer has to follow the same set of rules. So now, with the help of BACnet protocol, building owners can go for the expansion of their facilities with any manufacturer very easily without worrying about the compatibility. Now the idea of choosing the LabVIEW platform. Most of the supplier in nowadays are using the LabVIEW as a SCADA platform. Supervisory control and data acquisition system allows you to collect the information from different devices in one place. To establish the communication between their SCADA and BACnet device, they have to use some protocol converter, which converts the BACnet protocol into some other protocol which can be easily handled. But this type of converters are very costly and raise the overall budget of the project. With the help of LabVIEW VI, which is able to directly communicate with the BACnet device, can bring the overall cost down. BACnet protocol can be defined on the basis of different communication media like MSTP, which is master slave token passing, then BACnet IP, and then BACnet Ethernet, and so on. So in this video, we will perform the basic read property operation for analog and digital input over the BACnet IP. Let's start with the actual topic. This is our LabVIEW VI, which I have split it into two part, front panel and block diagram. To start the communication with BACnet device, whose command must be broadcast. Whose service is used by BACnet user to determine the device object identifier and network address and some other properties of devices which share the same internet work. The IAM service is used to respond to whois service request. However, the IAM service request may be issued at any point of time. It does not need to be preceded by the receipt of whois service request. To capture the BACnet packet in LabVIEW, UDP, User Datagram Protocol, is required. The UDP source and destinations port shall be set to BAC0. If we convert BAC0 in a decimal, so it will be like 47808. Just like whois and IAM palettes, we will place all the created library for different services which is required to perform this task. After arranging the whole VI, we can start our actual testing to see whether this VI is able to read the BACnet object or not. Due to unavailability of actual BACnet device, we will use the BACnet device simulator, which will create the BACnet environment. Trial version of this BACnet device simulator you can find on the link mentioned in description. This is the main window of BACnet device simulator looks like. Any BACnet device must contain the device object. The device object defines a standardized object whose properties represent the externally visible characteristic of BACnet device. There shall be exactly one device object in each device. To create a device object, right-click on BACnet network and select Add BACnet device. You can change the device ID and its name as per your requirement. Now to create the different object, right-click on the device, then select BACnet object. You can choose any BACnet object as per your requirement. In our case, we will perform the read properties, so we will use BACnet object type as analog input, followed by its instance number and its name. Same way, we will add the object for binary input. In our case, we will read 3 analog input and 2 digital input. Once you are done with the object creation, software will automatically start the operation. The actual connection between BACnet simulator and LabVIEW VI will look like this, in which BACnet simulator is running on small PC and LabVIEW on the big one, and both are connected with the red color Ethernet cable. Let's start the VI. After pressing the run button, VI has successfully fetched the different objects from simulated BACnet device running on different computer. Press button will start the reading of analog and digital values. As we can see that this LabVIEW VI is able to perform the BACnet communication without any help of external converter. In my next video, I will perform the write property for analog and digital channel. Thanks for watching.